بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، نصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، شر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد،
we finished generally the talking about the six pillars. أنتمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر. The six pillars of إيمان. Okay. Then, what Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah said, رحمه الله تعالى. What is his name? أحمد. His name أحمد. Like my name. Okay. خلاص. طيب. Then what he said? He said, ومن الإيمان بالله. الإيمان بما وصف به نفسه في كتابه العزيز وبما وصفه به رسوله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And also then he said, and from the إيمان and or part of the إيمان in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Okay, so now he's specifying or he's going more details in the first pillar. And if you remember, we said mainly in this book he talks about the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or mainly about the attributes of Allah, sifatillah. Why? Because subhanallah, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, generally, no differences in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No dispute or a big dispute or strong dispute in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Generally, the Muslims believe in the names of Allah. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Malik, Al-Quddus. But where is the problem? Or the problem more in the sifat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, وَمِنَ الْإِيمَانِ, to believe in what? In what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described himself in his book, كِتَابِهِ الْعَزِيزِ. It means the Quran. And also in what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described him. So now we have to believe in the sifatillah, in the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the Quran and Sunnah. From the Quran and from the Sunnah, and of course, when we say the Sunnah, we mean only the authentic Sunnah. We take only, we accept only the authentic hadith. Al-ahadith al-sahiha. Alaykum as-salam. And the sunnah, in the sunnah, sometimes sayings, sometimes actions, and also sometimes, or rarely, taqreer. Like what the Prophet ﷺ approved. Like what? Sayings. Like many hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or one of the attributes of Allah. يَضْحَكُ رَبُّنَا. Allah laughs at the two men, both of whom will enter paradise. They fight. But subhanallah, the killer and the killed, both of them, in Jannah, will be in the paradise. How? How? The killer, at the beginning, is not Muslim. He is fighting the Muslim. Then he will kill the Muslim, so the Muslim will be shaheed in Jannah. Later this, a non-Muslim killer will accept Islam. At the end, he will enter Jannah. So both of them will be in Jannah. Al-Qatil wal-Muqtul, the killer and the killed. So Allah will laugh. So the Prophet ﷺ said, يَضْحَكُ. So this is a sifa. This is one of the attributes of Allah, al-Dahik. From where we got this sifa? From a saying of the Prophet ﷺ. And sometimes from an action. How? You know the long hadith in Hajj. In the long hadith in Hajj. Okay, in one situations the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the situations the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a talk. He spoke in front of the people in Hajj. Then what he said? He raised his finger. Allahumma fashhad. Oh Allah, you are witness. He raised his finger up. Alaykum salam. Then he pointed at the people. So this is an action from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is Allah. That Allah is high, up. So this is an action from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the third one, taqreer, like approval from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he asked the girl, what he asked? Ayn Allah, where is Allah? What she said? She said, fi sama. Okay, what he answered? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not answer. I mean, he did not say anything after this question, but he gave another question. Who am I? What she said? She said, Anta Rasulullah, you are the messenger of Allah. He asked two questions. Hadith authentic in Sahih Muslim. Then, alaykum salam, what was the comment of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What he said to the Sahabi, the owner, the master of this girl? Free her. Why? Because she is mu'mina. So what does that mean when the Prophet ﷺ said she is mu'mina? It means he was agreeing with what she said or he disagreed? Agreed. So this is taqreer. This is called in the knowledge of hadith, sunnah taqreeriyya. Okay, there is sunnah qawliyya. The sunnah three types. Sunnah qawliyya. Something said by the Prophet ﷺ, sunnah fi'liya, an action, and sunnah taghriri, approval from the Prophet ﷺ. Okay, so we know the sifat by these three kinds from the sunnah. Of course, maybe you don't put this in the notes, Abu Fajr, not in the notes, but this is about knowledge of hadith or generally. The definition of sunnah, okay, alaykum salam, differs from one branch of sharia to another branch. Yeah, for example, in fiqh, what is the meaning of sunnah? It means something mustahab, recommended. But the word sunnah and the knowledge of hadith, they mean anything from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from his sayings, from his actions, approval, or description of his body or of his manners. So it is very wide in, from the knowledge of hadith. The definition of sunnah, okay, and the knowledge in the branch of mustalah al-hadith, when you study the hadith, it is different. Okay? And some of them make it shorter or they delete the, they remove the last two things. So they say the sunnah, anything from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a saying or action or approval. Okay. So we believe in the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which came from in the Quran. He said, "Kitabi fi kitabihi al-aziz, alaykum salam," or in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now he will repeat what we mentioned. من غير تحريف ولا تعطيل ولا من غير تكييف ولا تمثيل. We mentioned them. Okay, and now we are emphasizing this point. Why? Because this is very important point in this book. And the dispute between Ahl Sunnah and the others. Asha'ira, Maturidiyya, Kullabiyya, Kurramiyya. These different deviant sects. When we believe in the attributes of Allah, sifatillah, you should not change without tahrif. You remember, we said, what's meaning tahrif? Changing. Changing what? The meaning or the words. Changing the meaning or the words. This is not allowed. You have to take the word as it came in the Quran and authentic sunnah. Khalas. And we know the meaning. يعني for example Allah سبحانه وتعالى said الرحمن على العرش استوى. What is the meaning of the word استوى? It is known in the books of Arabic. It is known. But some of the deviant sects, they said no. استوى doesn't mean that Allah rose above the throne. No, it means Allah, يعني like يعني Allah took the throne from somebody else. And this is totally wrong. And even it is not in the Arabic language. Okay? So we should not change the meaning or the words. من غير ولا تعطيل, and without denying the names. يعني or the attributes. If you remember, we said there is a sect called Al-Mu'tazila. They say Allah is As-Sami' but without Sam. Allah is the hearer, but he doesn't hear. Allah is the most merciful, but he doesn't have mercy. Subhanallah, how? So this is called ta'til. No, we believe in the names and attributes. We believe that one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Hakim, the wise. And we believe in the attribute in this name, which is the wisdom. As simple as that, very simple. If you remember, a very important point, I mentioned the aqidah. I mean, to study the aqidah is very simple. I mean, the aqidah of Islam. But they made it very difficult. Also, number three, وَمِنْ غَيْرِ تَكْيِيف, without mentioning how is the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't mention. But we don't mean that there is no how for the action, the attributes of Allah. There is, but we don't know them. Because what we say, if usually, how we know the things, they say by three ways. يعني, for example, if you want to talk about one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his hand subhanahu wa ta'ala, or his eyes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. We ask you, did you see Allah? No. Did you see an example like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Anyone is like Allah? No. Did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe himself? Describe his hand or his eyes? Okay. No. So khalas, no way to know these things. I mean, to know the things, there are three ways. If I say, Wallah, I bought a car. What is your car? I tell you, this is my car. Khalas. Now you can know my car by seeing the car. This is number one. Number two, alaykum salam. I bought a car. What is your car? I tell you, do you see this car? Exactly, my car like this car. So when you see the similar, you know the thing. Number three, I tell you, I bought a car. What is your car? Wallahi, my car, it is, for example, Toyota 2018, Camry, يعني, with the, شسمة, GLX. So I describe the car in details, then you can imagine the car and you know the car. So now when we come to the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose above the throne. Did you see Allah? No. Did you see any similar to Allah? No. Did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describe how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went above the throne? No. Khalas. So don't speak about this issue. Don't speak about this issue. And we mentioned this last Saturday, that the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the needed questions. The hadith in the 40 hadith in Nawawi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the Sahaba what are the ways to get hasanat or to do charity. So charity doesn't mean only to give money. He said, when you say subhanallah, this is charity, when you say alhamdulillah, at the end, what he said? وَفِي بُضْعِ أَحَدِكُمْ صَدَقَةً. Even if you do the intercourse with your wife, this is charity. The Sahaba wondered, oh Rasulullah, how come? يعني we do something يعني desirable to us. We do our lust and we enjoy something and we get hasanat. It is sadaqah. The Prophet ﷺ said, okay, if he commit the haram, what will happen? He will be a sinner. So the opposite. If he do it in the halal way, he will get sadaqah. He will get hasanat. So what is the point Sheikh Uthaymeen said? He said, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, and be sure that the Sahaba asked the Prophet ﷺ the needed questions. So now this is a strange issue for them. So they asked him, khalas. But when the Prophet ﷺ taught the Sahaba this verse, ثم استوى على العرش, يا ما منعك أن تسجد لما خلقته بيدي, when Allah mentioned the two hands of him, سبحانه وتعالى, the Sahaba did not ask how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went above the throne. How is the hands of Allah? How are the hands of Allah? They did not ask. So what we should do? Also, we should not ask. Khalas? Okay. If it is not allowed for us to ask, what we should do? Believe. Khalas. You have to believe. You have to believe. Okay. And the fourth one, wala tamthil. When you believe in the attributes of Allah, don't say his hand is like the hand of this creature, similar to the man or similar to this kind of angel or no. This is not allowed. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, laysa kamithli shay. Bal yu'minun, the believers believe that Allah, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِي شَيْءٍ, nothing is like Allah. And he is the hearer, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the seer. خلاص. ما يصير سيف. شون قهوة وشاي. Okay. This ayah is very important. ليس كمثلي شيء وهو السميع البصير. This ayah has two parts. One part positive, one part negative. What I mean? ليس كمثلي شيء, negating. Nothing is like Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وهو السميع البصير, to prove. Why? Because ليس كمثلي شيء, some of them will, عليكم السلام, some of the deviant sects, okay, خلاص, this is good ayah for us. Allah doesn't have attributes. Okay, continue the ayah. The end of the ayah, وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Allah proved for himself these two names. And of course, all the names of Allah have attributes. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alaykum as-salam. يعني, the names of Allah subhanahu or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like us. If you remember what we said our names not necessary include our attributes. يعني, for example, my name is Khalid. What's the meaning of Khalid? Eternal. But of course I will die. So Khalid is only my name. But I don't have the attribute of this name. And some of the people, his name is Kareem. What does it mean, Kareem? Generous. But he is miser. Subhanallah. صح? And some of the people, his name is Nadir. And he's Nadir. You know Nadir? No, Nadir, rare. But he is not rare. Not all of them, but some of them, mashallah, rare. Unique, mashallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like us. The names of Allah with the attributes. يعني, Al-Hakim, the wise, it means he has the wisdom. Al-Sami', the hearer, he hears, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Rahman, Al-Rahim, merciful, beneficial, he has mercy. All of his names. The king, he has kingdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Malik, he has that, he owns, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Malik, the owner. So all the names of Allah have the attributes. This is very important. Very important. Why? Because they say, they claim, no, Allah has names but without attributes. This is totally wrong. Maybe you ask, why do you want to detach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the names of Allah or the attributes of Allah from His names? They prove the names but they don't believe in the attributes. Why? What is the problem with them? The problem with them is التمثيل. Okay? They imagine that Allah has like our parts, subhanahu wa ta'ala, like our attributes. Yani when they think about the, for example, the hand, it just came in the Quran. Allah has hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created Adam by his hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately they think that the hands of Allah like our hand. So, subhanallah, the beginning of this sect is resembling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his creatures. Okay? So they say his hand like our hand. Then they say, but this is not acceptable. Okay, now what is the solution? Ah, good idea. The solution, Allah doesn't have hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what they say, kullu mu'attil mumathil, every person who negates and who denies the attributes of Allah, his start is tamthil, resembling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his creation. So they want to escape from one problem and they went to a bigger problem or another problem. But what is the simple thinking? We should think like what Allah told us in the ayah. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Nothing is like Allah. You have hands and also Allah has hands. But our hands are not like the hands of Allah. Why? Because He is not like us. He is the creator and we are created. Very simple. If you take it simple, it will be simple. If you try to complicate it, it will be complicated. So, أهل السنة والجماعة لا ينفون عنه ما وصف به نفسه. They don't deny the attributes that he described himself, سبحانه وتعالى. And they don't change the words, the meanings or the words. They don't have tahrif. Also, ولا يلحدون في أسمائه وأسمائه وآياته. Okay. This term is important. It came in the Quran. Okay. What is this term? Al-ilhad. Al-ilhad. Muhammad, نقدر نفتح تكييف؟ تكييف نقدر نفتحه؟ تكييف. You feel hot? طيب. The term al-ilhad. It is in the Quran. Where? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَ فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ. Okay. Surah Al-A'raf. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the great names, the perfect names. الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَ, the perfect names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَ فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. So invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by using His names. وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ, and leave those who deviate in His names. Okay, what is the meaning of ilhad, or what are the types of ilhad? Okay, there is one of them, or number one, to deny the names of Allah. Okay, what's the meaning of ilhad? If you remember what we said, ilhad in the Arabic language, it means to deviate. Okay, you should go straight, but these people are deviating from this straight path. So ilhad. And the names of Allah, number one, to deny the name. Of course, this is very deviant sect. who deny, this sect denies the names of Allah. They deny the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, Allah, only one name, Allah. Why? And then other names. They said, no. If we say that Allah has more than one name, it means there are multiple gods. What is the problem? Sometimes the person has more than one name. Yani people call me Ahmed, or they call me Abu Abdurrahman. They call me Ar-Rum. What is the problem? And also the things, the sword, or the lion. Okay, so different names, or more than one name, doesn't mean that different people. So they are very deviant. So this number one, al-ilhad, deviating in the names of Allah. Number one, to deny the names of Allah. Number two, denying the attributes of Allah. This is also deviation. Number three, giving names to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from the Quran or Sunnah. Like what? Like he gave the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the name Al-Ab, the Father. Okay? Or they give different names. It's not allowed. Yes, we should be careful in the translation. I noticed this mistake. Yani, when the ayah or the hadith, there is the word Allah, you should put the word Allah. Don't remove the word Allah and you put God. Okay, be careful about this. Okay, so don't give any name to Allah without a proof from the Quran or authentic Sunnah. This is number three. Number four, giving to the idols names from the names of Allah. Like the kuffar, they have Al-Lat wal-Uzza. They say Al-Lat from the word Allah, Al-Uzza from the word Al-Aziz. This is not allowed. Taking from the names of Allah, this is not allowed. Haram. Okay. So all these four kinds of deviation under the term of ilhad. Are you with me or difficult? Huh? Difficult, Abu Fatma? Okay. Ready for the exam? What do you mean like before? You failed the exam or what? You did not do the exam, huh? You will give to your daughter, she will solve the exam, huh? Because she made the exam. Wasta. طيب. So he said, وَلَا يُلْحِدُونَ, we don't deviate in the names of Allah or in his ayatihi. Okay. The word ayatihi. Okay. Any question? Saif is making problems? Huh? Trouble. Shkila. Yes, yani the kuffar, what are the main idols in the kuffar? Al-Lat wal-Uzza. Allah mentioned Surah Al-Najm, أَفَرَأَيْتُ مِنْ لَاتَ وَالْعُزَّى وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى Al-Lat wal-Uzza, Mana. The kuffar took these names from the names of Allah. Al-Lat from Allah. Al-Uzza from Al-Aziz. Mana from Al-Mannan. This is haram, not allowed. In this, yeah, like this way, this is haram.
Yeah, but idols are haram anyways.
I know, this is haram. No doubt, of course, this is shirk to worship the. But this is a kind of deviating the names of Allah. Now we are talking about the names of Allah. What is the meaning that misunderstanding in the names of Allah? To take names from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to their idols. We mean this point, no doubt, the idol is haram. I mean, more sin. And worse, of course, worshipping the idols is haram, major shirk. And it will be worse and worse if they are taking names from Allah to their idols. Yes?
It's like Khuda, it's not a perfect meaning. We cannot say any other names other than Allah.
Don't say Khuda is one of the names of Allah. Don't say God is one of the names of Allah. It's not allowed. It's not allowed. Okay? Because Khuda, what Khuda means? It means Allah or it means the God? No. Or it means God?
It just means God. It's a language.
Yes.
So like some preachers, they say other
religions. If they claim Allah, this is one of the names of Allah, they should bring a proof from the Quran or Sunnah. The word Khuda. طيب. Yes, yes. العزيز.
But if we go to the history, then these were the pious people. Like God was a pious man, and Uzza was some other man, pious man, and they made idol out of that. Then how they have created these names?
Uzza, a pious man.
Lot,
yes. Some of the scholars said the Lot was a man who was preparing the food for the Hajj. This is one of the opinion. The other opinion, Lot is from the word Allah.
Uzza, there is no proof that he's a pious.
I don't know. But generally, scholars mentioned that they took these names from the Allah's names, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So, this is deviation in the names of Allah, and he said, وَآيَاتِهِ. Okay, the word ayat, it has two meanings. There is something called al-ayat al-kawniyya wa al-ayat al-shar'iyya. Okay, ayat is plural of ayah. It means the sign. The sun is ayah. The moon also ayah. Okay, the camels also ayah. Okay, all of these signs lead to believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are called ayat kawniyya, universal signs. The other type, al-ayat al-shar'iyya, the verses, it means the verses in the Quran and Sunnah. Okay, these are ayat shar'iyya. Okay, so here he means which ayat, the universal ayat or the sharia ayat. Here we are talking about the sharia, about the Quran. We should not deviate in understanding the verses in the Quran. Okay. What he said, وَلَا يُكَيِّفُونَ. And they don't mention how are the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يُمَثِلُونَ صِفَاتِهِ بِصِفَاتِ خَلْقِهِ. They don't try to say his attributes like the attributes of his creation. This is not allowed. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? لِأَنَّهُ لَا سَمِيَ لَهُ ولا كفء له ولا ند له ولا يقاس بخلقه سبحانه وتعالى. Why we don't say the attributes of Allah not like our attributes? He said because nothing is like Allah. Nothing is like Allah. If there is something like Allah, then you can't say the attributes of that thing like Allah سبحانه وتعالى. But nothing is like Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ليس كمثله شيء. Okay. لا سمية ولا كفء ولا ند. These three terms, السمي والكفء, يعني almost the same. Almost the same. Okay. Nothing is like Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ند. Okay. Something equal. Nothing is equal to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Okay. ولا يقاس بخلقه. You cannot make قياس. Okay. About the qiyas, okay, some scholars said we can do, or there is a possibility that we do only one kind of qiyas, because there are different types of qiyas. Some of them said qiyas means analogical deduction, similarity. Okay, what we said about the hadith in the 40 Nawawiya, we said this is called qiyasul aks. There are different types of qiyas. Okay, what's mean qiyasul aks? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you do the intercourse, if you do adultery, this is haram, you will be a sinner. But if you do this with your wife, this is halal and you will get ajr. This is called the opposite qiyas. This is one kind of qiyas. But there are different types. One of them, some of the scholars said, we can use this with Allah, which is called qiyasul awla. What is the meaning of qiyasul awla? Qiyasul awla, now we believe that Allah is higher than us because He is the creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we consider something perfect for us, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can take this perfection. Okay, in fiqh, okay, or from the Quran, like what an example of qiyasul awla? Yani Allah said in the Quran, subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not allowed to say to your mother or to your parents the word uff. Okay, so now what about beating the mother? A'udhu billah, this is worse. Okay, but it is not mentioned in the Quran. If somebody told you, it is not mentioned in the Quran that beating the mother is haram, what do you tell him? You tell him, okay, this is okay, this is halal, because we don't have a proof? What do you tell him? So this is called qiyas al-awla. If the small thing is haram, so no doubt the bigger is haram. And more haram. Saying off is not allowed. So insulting the mother, beating the mother, this is more haram. From where? It is not mentioned in the Quran. No, because Allah mentioned something less, so what is more is haram. This is called qiyas al-awla. So some scholars said, maybe we can use this kind of qiyas, similarity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Then he said, فإنه أعلم بنفسه وبغيره وأصدق قيل وأحسن حديثا من خلقه. Why we should stick to the Quran and Sunnah? Why we should not change any meaning, any word from the Quran and Sunnah? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows Himself and He knows others, okay, more than the others. فَإِنَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِنَفْسِهِ. Because Allah knows Himself more than us. Who knows Allah more, we or Him? Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is number one, because he is more knowledgeable. أَعْلَمُ وَأَصْدَقُ, truthfulness, from the صدق. وأحسن, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you the perfect words. يعني for example, now if I tell you, yalla, speak about yourself, describe yourself, no doubt there are some issues you cannot describe yourself. Can you mention, for example, how many white blood cells inside your body? Okay, the length of your finger exactly. Can you mention this? Even sometimes you cannot describe yourself exactly. Yes, you can say your name, from where, and your nationality, how many chapters from the Quran memorized, but you cannot describe everything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no, He knows Himself. Why? Because He is al-Aleem, the knower subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, when Allah says, He always saying the truth, asdaq. But we, sometimes we tell the lies. intentionally. And sometimes we tell something by mistake. So there is possibility of telling them the wrong information. And also ahsan. Yani, sometimes or many times we cannot give the good expression. I cannot express exactly the word I mean it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He says something, He knows it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He means it. إذن Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أعلم وأصدق وأحسن. Allah more knowledgeable, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وأصدق truthfulness more, and أحسن in expressing what He wants. So don't come to any verse in the Quran and you say Allah means this meaning in this ayah. Why? Do you know if you say, no, Allah doesn't mean this, but He means that, as if you are accusing Allah, a'udhu billah, accusing Allah that He did not clarify what He wants, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many times in the Quran, you see or we read the word bayinat. What does it mean, bayinat? I think also in Urdu, sah? Bayinat. Is it Urdu? What's mean bayinat? Bayin, bayinat. Clear. Urdu ba'chili wala la? Mu lazim Urdu, khalas. Bayinat, something clear. Clear proofs. Many times in the Quran, Allah mentioned the word bayinat. So the Quran is clear. Nothing is hidden in the Quran. So the problem, when you come to a verse, a word in the Quran, and you say, no, this word means this or that. What do you mean? Do you mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give us the good expression or the good term here? Or He gave us a difficult word? A'udhu billah. No. Allah is telling us what is clear for the people to understand. Then he said, ثُمَّ, then after that, the messengers of Allah, صادقون مصدوقون. The messengers of Allah tell the truth, and also they have the truth, or they have the support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the ayat, or there is a term, miracles, mu'jizat. The messengers always tell the truth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the miracles to support them. What is the proof that you are a prophet? You are a messenger? Show us something. Allah gave, for example, Salih alayhi salam, what He gave him? The camel, or the she camel, naqa. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the moon, split. Okay, Isa alayhi salam, Allah gave him that he can tell them what you hide inside your houses. Food, okay. He blew inside the bird made of clay, and this bird will become alive. All of them miracles. Or some of the scholars don't like to use the word mu'jiza. Okay? Why? Because it is not mentioned in the Quran or Sunnah. Okay, what is the correct term? Ayah. Okay, ayat. The signs. Then he said, Rahimallah, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, بخلاف الذين يقولون عليه ما لا يعلمون. So we are not, he means Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, not like the deviant sects who claim not in the Quran and Sunnah, and they claim something without knowledge. From where you brought this term or this word or this attribute? You don't have a proof because of lack of knowledge. لهذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to clear himself from all the accusations from the wrongdoers, الظالمين, the bad people who gave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrong attributes without proofs. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clearing himself from these doubts. عَمَّا يَصُفُونَ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Peace upon the messengers and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the العالمين, the universe. فَسَبَّحَ نَفْسَهُ عَمَّا وَصَفَهُ بِهِ الْمُخَالِفُونَ. What is the meaning of the term تسبيح? When we say سبحان الله, innocent? شو معناتها؟ تنزيه. It means you are negating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from any deficiency. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means Allah is perfect. When you say that the word subhanallah. Subhanallah means Allah is perfect. No defects in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not like us. We are incomplete. You are incomplete. But Allah is perfect. So that's why we say Subhanallah. If they claim that Allah has a son, we should say Subhanallah. Why? Because this is deficiency. If Allah has a son, a'udhu billah. We have sons, children. We have parents, but Allah, no. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. فسبح نفسه عما وصفه به المخالفون للرسل وسلم على المرسلين لسلامة ما قالوه من النقص والعيب. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, peace upon the messengers. Why? Because what they said is perfect and correct without any mistakes about the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهو سبحانه قد جمع فيما وصفه وسمى به نفسه بين النفي والإثبات. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put together the negation and the proof, proving. Like the word of La ilaha illallah. What the statement La ilaha illallah includes? Two parts, negation and proving. La ilaha, there is no true God. Illallah, affirming, proving that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the true God. So we need both of them. We need both of them. I'll go more details. It is an important point about an-nafi wal-ithbat. There is an important issue here about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his attributes. اللي هو النفي والإثبات. Negating and affirming. Now, if I say Allah is as-sami', this is negating or affirming? If I say Allah لم يلد ولم يولد, he doesn't have children and also he did not born. Negation. Okay. So these are two types. If you see the Quran, if you read the Quran, what you will find, you find the negation more or the affirming more? Affirming. In details or general verses? Details. Okay. Look, what Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they say, the scholars, they say affirming the names and attributes more in details. What we mean more in details? يعني you'll find الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن, many names, many attributes in details. Okay? While if you go to the negating, how many verses and hadith negating in details? More or less? Few. يعني for example, لا تأخذوا سنة ولا نوم. Allah doesn't sleep, سبحانه وتعالى. ولم يكن له لم يلد ولم يولد. He doesn't have children, سبحانه وتعالى. So if you count them, you'll find relatively they are very few. The negating. And you will find negating verses general. ليس كمثلي شيء. Nothing is like Allah. This is details or general? General. Okay. هل تعلم له سمية? Do you know anyone like Allah? This is specific or general? Details or general? General. So this is okay, important in the Quran and Sunnah. In the way of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. When we affirm the names and attributes, details and the details more. When we negate, less. While the people of Bid'ah, what they do, you'll find negating in details. And this is wrong. What they say, Allah is not up, Allah is not down, Allah is not right, Allah is not left, Allah is not inside the world, Allah is not outside the world. You'll see many negating. And this is totally wrong. Why? Because it is not in the Quran and Sunnah. Yani even by logic, imagine there is, okay, yeah, for example, if you go to your mudir, if you go to your boss, and you tell him, okay, wallah, you are not a cleaner, you are not dirty, you are not oppressor, what do you think? He will be happy? He will not accept this, صح? But imagine if you mention the details, you are brave, you are generous, you are strong, you are, this is good or bad? Good. So subhanAllah, يعني, these people, I mean the deviant sects, don't accept what they are describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them. So what about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So our way, I mean the way of the Quran, when you describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in details, what we are affirming for him. Ar-Rahman, Rahim, Malik al-Quddus, Salam, Al-Muhaymin. Allah is above the throne, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has hands, Allah has eyes, Allah. So we mention what is mentioned in the Quran. And when we negate, you will find general ayat and few. This is the way. This is the way. Good question, huh? For the exam. Okay? طيب. So we, he said, فلا عدول لأهل السنة والجماعة ما جاء به المرسلون. He said, the people of أهل السنة والجماعة cannot leave the way of the messengers. Why? Because it is the straight path, صراط مستقيم. صراط الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. What is the straight path? It is the straight of the prophets, truthfulness people. Shuhada, martyrs, salihin, pious people, righteous people. وقد دخل في هذه الجملة ما وصف به نفسه في سورة الإخلاص. And what is in this sentence, okay, what is came in سورة الإخلاص, which equals one third of the Quran. قل هو الله أحد, الله الصمد, لم يلد ولم يولد, ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Now, Surah Al-Ikhlas. This is, I think, hot, huh? Flies. قام تذبح تحرق الحشرات. طيب. Now, Surah Al-Ikhlas. Subhanallah, only four verses. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, it equals to one third of the Quran. He mentioned the hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, احشدوا. He said to the sahaba, احشدوا, يعني come close to me. Come close to me. I will recite one third of the Quran. MashaAllah. شلون, how? Then he recited, قل هو الله أحد. He recited, قل هو الله أحد. He said, it equals to one third of the Quran. Okay. Now, what is the meaning that the Prophet ﷺ said, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, one third of the Quran. The scholars say, فِي الْجَزَاءُ وَلَيْسَ فِي الْإِجْزَاءُ. يعني it is one third of the Quran and the reward. It doesn't mean reading 10 chapters from the Quran. They mean في الجزاء, in the reward. يعني if you say قل هو الله أحد, Allah will give you the reward of reading 10 chapters of the Quran. But reading 10 chapters, يعني for example, if you, يعني when you say, والله I want to read 10 chapters from the Quran, okay, then you say, I read قل هو الله أحد, okay? If you say, يعني والله, by Allah as a verb, this will not be accepted. This will not be accepted, okay? So it is in the ajr, in the reward, but not in the practice. Okay? They say the scholars في الجزاء وليس في الإجزاء. طيب. Why it is one third of the Quran? They say because if you see the Quran, if you look generally at the Quran, what you will find? You will find the Quran three parts. One part, Aqidah, talking about the Aqidah, the decree. The second part talking about the ahkam, the rules, halal, haram. The third part talking about akhbar. What happened to the people of Nuh, Yusuf, the stories. And this surah totally about what? Aqidah. So that's why it is one third of the Quran. If you see the Quran, subhanallah, general, what is in the Quran? Aqidah, stories, and rules. And this surah about the Aqidah. That's why it is one third of the Quran. طيب. قل هو الله أحد, الله الصمد, affirming. لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد, negating. Half of the surah affirming, the other half negating. What's the meaning of أحد? One. قل هو الله أحد. طيب. What's the meaning of الصمد? Okay. Okay. Master. Okay. طيب. More than one meaning. Okay. الصمد. Okay. One of the meanings. Okay. And يعني sometimes subhanallah you'll find all the meanings go around one concept. الصمد, it means the thing which doesn't have a hollow inside. Yeah, like now, the human being. What we have? We have the gut, the opening from the mouth, esophagus, stomach. Okay, what does it mean that we have a stomach? It means we need to eat to fill the stomach. And after filling, we need to get rid of, subhanallah, the unneeded food. So, it means we are needy. So, when we say Allah, as-samad, who doesn't have hollow, subhanallah, it means he doesn't need. And everything need him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so as-samad is this is one meaning, who doesn't have a hollow inside. Another meaning, the master, who is perfect. And the master who is perfect. السيد الكامل سبحانه وتعالى. Why? Because there are some masters not perfect. He is master, but subhanallah, even he cannot control his children or his soldiers. But Allah, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything we submit to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-samad. لم يلد ولم يولد. What's the meaning لم يلد? Huh? لم يلد. He doesn't have birth. Now, لم يلد, Allah says, سبحانه وتعالى, لم يلد ولم يولد. What's the meaning لم يلد? He doesn't give birth, صح? ولم يولد? He wasn't born. Okay. Subhanallah, if you notice, Allah mentioned that. Let me, now, which is worse? I mean, both of them wrong, totally wrong. But which one is worse? The second. Okay. Why it is second and worse? If it is worse, it should be beginning. They say, because subhanallah, no one claimed that Allah has parents. But there are people who claim that Allah has children. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودِ عُزَيْرٌ ابْنُ اللَّهِ. Okay. All this time. Sorry.
No, this is not this is camera. This is camera. Now we can start again. Okay.
طيب. So. وقالت اليهود عزير بن الله. So they claim that عزير is the son of Allah. وقالت النصارى المسيح بن الله. Okay. So, but do you know that anyone claimed that Allah has parents or father? So half of the surah affirming, the other half negating. ولم يكن له كفوا. There is a common mistake in reciting this ayah. Okay, many Muslims, when they recite this ayah, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدٌ. This is wrong. How you should recite? وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا فَ. There is dhamma. You should say كُفُوًا. كُفُوًا. Don't say كُفْوًا. Important, this is important. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. This is correct. And where is the mistake? وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. This is wrong. Okay? This is common mistake. طيب. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Allah subhanahu described himself in this surah, what is called Al-Ikhlas. Okay? And also, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described himself in the best ayah. Which is the best ayah? Ayah al-Kursi. And what is the best surah? Al-Fatiha. Fatiha. The best surah is Al-Fatiha. The best ayah is Ayah al-Kursi. Then he mentioned the ayah. Allahu la ilaha illa hu al-hayy al-qayyum. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know Allah la ilaha illahu. This is the kalima, kalima al-tawheed. What does it mean al-hay? Ever living, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his life is not like our life. Why? Because we have a start and we have end. And also our life full of suffering, subhanallah. Today you are sick. Tomorrow you are sad. After tomorrow you are happy. Then you are angry. You are crazy. You are all everything. Crazy? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no. His life is not our life. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. ليس كمثلي شيء. Nothing is like Allah. His life is perfect. Not like our life. How his life is perfect? هو الأول. He is the first. Nothing is before him. هو الأول. والآخر is the last and nothing after him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't die. وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلْ حَيْءَ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. And put your trust in the one who is alive and doesn't die, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu la ilaha illa hu al-hay. This is the meaning of al-hay. Al-qayyum. What is meaning of al-qayyum? هذا نص التعريف. This is half of the definition. Sustains and protects? No. He said half of the definition. Who is controlling everything? He's providing everything for the others. This is half. But this half of the definition. What does God say? القائم بنفسه والمقيم لغيره. Who doesn't need others. Who is sufficient for himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal muqim li ghayri, everything is dependent on him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Two parts. Al-qa'a bi nafsihi, he is independent, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't need. He is living alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-hayy, alone. And also everything dependent on him. Al-qa'a bi nafsihi, wal muqim li ghayri. But we cannot live without him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot live alone. I need the air. I need the water. I need the friends. I need the wife. I need the mother. We cannot live alone. But him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's living alone. He doesn't need, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So this is meaning al-qayyum. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. He doesn't know. Of course, you know what it means. No sleeping. He doesn't sleep. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sina. What does it mean? Sina. Sina. For example, if you are tired, like not some of you today, the other days. Okay, during the halqa. Huh? It is not like nab. Something like dizzy, dizziness, huh? Slumber. We have examples today? No, today no. Today okay. Usually we have examples, but today, alhamdulillah, you are good today. No?
No sofa.
No sofa. طيب. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't sleep, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't take nap, doesn't fall in dizziness, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تأخذ سنة ولا نوم. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم. I will not go through all the ayah, but we'll take the attributes. يعلم. He knows ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم. He knows the future and the past, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shouldn't I have the notes or exam?
Exam.
La, why you're safe? Please, yani, I cannot, the problem, two faces that exam. I cannot say cover the exam. Okay? It's a big problem, huh? Tell us, don't look at the exam. Okay? So Allah knows everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Wasi'a. Okay? Wasi'a kursiyu samawati wal ard. His kursi. Now we have here the word kursi. Okay. What is the meaning of kursi? Okay. The kursi here doesn't mean the common meaning, what we know. But there is also another meaning in the Arabic language. The kursi here means like this small table which usually the kings put under their feet. Huh? Stool? Stool? What is the spelling? S-T-O-L. Okay. S-T-O-L. Okay, that's two. Okay, so this is this doesn't mean the chair. Okay, and also doesn't mean the throne. Because maybe in some tafsir you'll find kursi means the throne. No. Al-arsh is the throne. Shil, safe, hada. Shil, wara. La. Safe. هذا امتحان شيل كله شيل مرة ثانية. Who paid him? Somebody paid him dinar or something?
Right.
طيب. Okay. We have العرش and we have الكرسي. العرش is different than الكرسي. العرش is the throne of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. الكرسي is the place of the feet. Where they put the feet. Okay, subhanAllah, his kursi وسع كرسي السماوات والأرض. His كرسي is bigger than the heavens and the earth. سبحانه وتعالى. Can we say here كرسي means knowledge? His knowledge is wide and vast. سبحانه وتعالى. Can we say كرسي knowledge? No. This is one kind of the changing the meaning. تحريف. And subhanallah, you find this in some of the tafsir. Some of the tafsir, they say kursi means knowledge. Subhanallah, from where this meaning? This is from the shaitan. This is from the shaitan. Okay? And we have tafsir, Ibn Kathir said, Al-Hasan al-Basri explain the word al-kursi, that the place of the feet. Okay? And also Ibn Abbas, one of the scholars, famous scholars of hadith, Abu Zur'ah, he said the tafsir from Abdullah ibn Abbas, the explanation of this ayah from Abdullah ibn Abbas, that the kursi means the place of the feet. At the end of the ayah, Allah said, وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. What's the meaning of Ali? They said three things. Allah is high in three things. Allah is high by Himself. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is above everything. Not only the throne, above everything. And also, Ali, it means in His honor, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, His honor is very high. وعلو قهر, also he is high in his power, سبحانه وتعالى. So Allah is high in three things: in his power, in his honor, in his place, سبحانه وتعالى, by himself, سبحانه وتعالى. علي, العظيم, you know العظيم, the great, سبحانه وتعالى. Then Shaykh Islam Taymi said, رحمه الله, and that's why when you read this ayah at night, Allah will protect you. And the shaitan will not come close to you until the morning. From where he took this? From the hadith. The famous hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Abu Hurairah, protect the money of the Muslims, or يعني بيت الزكاة. Okay? The wealth of the, like the government. So, Abu Hurairah was guarding the place. Then he saw a man stealing from the food. Abu Hurairah caught him. Ta'al, come. Why are you stealing? He said, please, I am a poor man. I have children. Leave me. I will not come to this again. I will not steal again. Then Abu Hurairah released him. Tomorrow or the next night, the same thing. He came stealing from the food. You promised you will not come, but now you came again. He said, please. He started to apologize, lying. Abu Hurairah released him, radiallahu ta'ala. The third night, said, when he caught him, he said, this time I will take you to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are lying the third time. Then this man said, please leave me and I will tell you something to protect yourself. When you come tonight, at night, recite Ayatul Kursi, Allah will protect you. Until the morning. Then the Prophet, when Abu Hurairah told the Prophet ﷺ the full story, the Prophet ﷺ said, صدقك وهو كذوب ذاك شيطان. He told you the truth, but he is a liar. He told you the truth, and he is a liar. How come? Yes, it can't happen. Maybe the person is a big liar, but he can't tell the truth maybe once in his life. Or once a year. This is shaitan. So this is the strength in this verse, ayat al-kursi. If you recite it at night, Allah will protect you. So recite this ayah when you, before sleeping, and teach your children to recite this ayah before sleeping. Okay. So now Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah will mention the ayat which include the names and attributes of Allah. Why he is doing this? Because he wants to do the opposite of the deviant sects. He wants to follow the way of the Quran. Because subhanAllah, deviant sects, what they are doing, Allah is not up, Allah is not high. They negate in details. And Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah wants to show them the opposite from the Quran. Look what is in the Quran. Allah is affirming, proving His attributes in the Quran in details. So Allah is saying, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. Rely on, put your trust in the one who is alive and who doesn't die. This is very strong ayah. This ayah is important for us. And also it is important to tell the people who go around the graves. They go to the dead people and they ask them, why you ask them? And they are dead. Depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Put your trust in Allah. Rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because Allah doesn't die. As simple as that.
لا يموت subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this surah Furqan. Another ayah, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَهُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. He is the knower. Allah knows. It is important in the aqeedah to know the names of Allah. What is the importance? The importance like this ayah in Surah Al-Tahrim. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. He is the knower and also he is the wise. Now, if you believe that Allah is the knower, Al-Alim, and if you believe that Allah is the wise, and something happened to you, for example, a car accident, you lost your business, or while you are, يعني, you went to Salat Al-Fajr, for example, and somebody stole your pocket money. Okay? Maybe you'll say, if I sit at home, this will not happen. People who are sleeping or people who are praying at home, they are safe and I lost my money because I paid in the masjid. But if you come back to these two names, Allah is knower and Allah is the wise, you will feel comfortable. Khalas, alhamdulillah. Allah knows what is happening and what will happen. And Allah is the wise. Allah knows why He is doing this, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you will submit and you will feel totally comfortable. But imagine if you don't have this belief, why this happening to me? I will not pray Fajr in the masjid again. Subhanallah. Some people like this. I will tell you, yani, this is common. If you follow the rules, okay, in your religion or in dunya, okay, sometimes you face problems. Yani, sometimes because of your beard, they will delay you in the airport in some countries. صح? Because of what? Because of your beard. Or because of the niqab of your wife, the hijab of your wife. Or they will catch you, they will take you to the police station because you pray al-Fajr in the masjid. In some countries, they catch them, they say, come, why you are praying every day in the masjid? Okay? So, subhanAllah, maybe some people, why I should do this? خلاص. No, you should believe that Allah is the wise. Allah wants to test you, to examine you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is very important to know the names of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما أصاب مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها. Allah said in the Quran, any calamity happened to you, it is written before it happened. It means Allah knows everything. Al-Alim subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why you are sad? Why you are sad? Say Alhamdulillah, khalas. So it is very important to know the names of Allah and very important to believe in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another surah, Surah Saba, he said, وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. He is the wise and also he is al-khabir. Okay. Look, there is al-khabir, al-latif, al-alim. Al-alim, who is the knower, who knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. Al-khabir, there is relation between Khabir and Al-Alim. But Al-Khabir more specifically to the hidden things. And Al-Latif specifically to the tiniest, minute things. Small things. Subhanallah. Okay? Be sure that all the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll not find two identical names totally. There should be something different. Like Al-Ghafur and Al-Ghaffar. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of them, what's the meaning of Al-Ghafur? What is the origin and the source of this word? To forgive. صح? So what the scholar said, Al-Ghafur, okay, one of them, the one who forgives the many sins. And Al-Ghaffar, the big sins. Huh? Al-Ghafir, no. No, Ghafir is not one of the names of Allah. Al-Ghafur, Al-Ghaffar, but not Ghafir. Okay? Not Ghafir. طيب. So, here we have Al-Hakim Al-Khabir. And the next ayah, Surah Al-An'am. وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهُ إِلَّهُ Then Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرْ He knows what is in the desert. وَالْبَحْرِ In the sea. And وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا Any leaf falls, he knows. How many leaves fall every day? Continuous. Allah knows them. Exactly. What is the time and the number and the place? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we don't know. And even we cannot count them. Allah knows them. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ And every seed, okay, in the darkness in the earth, ولا رطب ولا يابس, anything wet, anything dry, everything is written in a clear book. Surah Al-An'am, okay, Surah Fussilat, وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تضع إلا بعلمه. Any أنثى, what's أنثى? Female, not only human beings, female, human beings, animals, jinn. Okay, Allah knows what they carry in their wombs and when they deliver, what they deliver. Allah knows exactly, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Fussilat. Okay, also, لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا Surah Al-Talaq, Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's to know that Allah is able. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can do, okay, everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Qadir, one of the names of Allah, Al-Qadir, and Al-Qadir, 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 subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay, ala kulli shayin Qadir, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ability of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Qudra, wa anna Allah qad ahata bi kulli shayin ilma, the knowledge of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, nothing can escape from the knowledge of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing can be hidden. Surah Al-Talaq. Then Surah Al-Dhariyat, Inna Allah huwa al-Razzaq dhul quwwati al-Mateen. Allah is al-Razzaq, who gives the who sustains, subhanahu wa ta'ala, sustenance, who gives the sustenance. Al-Razzaq dhul quwwati al-Mateen, the power, the strength, subhanallah, al-Mateen. Okay, they are related. Okay, from the word strong, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what they say, al-mateen, okay, who is يعني, very strong, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And al-qawi, whose strength became or reached to the highest level. He is very strong and also perfect in his strength, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Surah Al-Shura, وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He hears, subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything, any time, any language. Al-Basir, he can see everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everywhere. Even the jinn, what we cannot see, he can see, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, and also the next ayah, It is written, it is mentioned Sami'an Basira. Okay. And this ayah in Surah Al-Nisa', what he said, Inna Allah kana Sami'an Basira. Here, what you understand from the word kana? Kan. It was. Okay? But in Arabic language, kana doesn't mean necessarily something in the past and finish. No. It means also, in Arabic language, something continuous also. يعني it means Allah is the hearer and the seer, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, at least don't understand when you see the word kana, don't understand something in the past and finished. No. For Allah, it means continuous, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means Allah is the hearer and the seer, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alaykum as-salam. Also, I will end up with this point. As-sam' As-sami' okay. Who subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows everything can be heard. This is one of the meaning. Another meaning, okay, who accepts subhanahu wa ta'ala and who answers subhanahu wa ta'ala after the ruku'. What we say, sami Allah liman hamida. Here, what does it mean, sami Allah? Yani Allah answers those who praise him. Allah answers and gives who those who praise him. So here, سمع الله لمن حمده, it doesn't mean Allah hears those who praise him. No doubt, of course, he hears them. He hears them. But here it means he answers them. يعني what they say, السمع نوعان, سمع إدراك وسمع إجابة. Two types of hearing. سمع إدراك means the general meaning, what we know. And the other one, the hearing, it means the answering. Okay? جزاكم الله خير, صلى الله عليه وسلم.